Today we're going to take a look at the new auto tagging API feature within Adobe Acrobat. Welcome to the Accessibility Guide channel. My name is Sean Jordison and we have another new topic just for you. Before we jump in though, please take a moment to hit that subscribe button. It really helps me out. Now let's check out this auto tagging API. To ensure that we have the new auto tagging feature enabled, we're going to select the menu button and then select preferences. Under the accessibility tab, there's an option called enable cloud-based auto tagging for accessibility and then select okay. Next, we're going to open up our prepare for accessibility button and then we're going to select auto tag document. And this is a 19-page file. Now that we've ran the new API auto tagger, let's take a look at it. The first thing that I notice is that all of the tags are nested inside of the document tab. That is a fantastic start. Then we have a figure tag that contains some of this text on the far left side, a P tag, and then an H1 tag, followed by a couple of heading 2 tags. Now, this isn't perfect by any means, but it is a decent start to having some of this content properly tagged. This is interesting. It put all of this information into an aside. This actually seems to be like a table of contents almost at the end of the page, but I like the way that Adobe put this inside of an aside tag. This makes it simple for us to collapse the menu and actually make adjustments as needed. We have a heading level 2. We then have several other P tags and an additional aside area. Again, this is beneficial because all of this text on the right-hand side in the sidebar, this often needs to be tagged slightly different. Like you would either want to artifact this content because it disrupts the flow of the regular reading order, or you would want to have it appear at the end of the paragraph. So in this case, the paragraph actually ends on the next page. So I'm going to move that P tag up to the end of that other paragraph. And then we have our aside content, which we then can move on to the next paragraph. Now, this is just one method that you could tag this type of content. We could also put it completely at the end of the section if we wanted to, or before this heading content. It really just depends. As I am down arrowing through the content, I'm just looking at some of this information. It looks like we have a properly formatted list item, and then it goes directly into a heading, the aside content again, and then into the paragraph elements. We have a properly formatted H3 tag. We then have the figure tags, which are, they need a little bit of fixing, but it got three of them completely right, which is actually impressive. Let's take a look and see if there's any alternate text on these. I'm going to right click the figure tag and select properties, and there is not any alternate text. That's okay. Let's go ahead and keep down arrowing through this content. And again, the aside content is all together, which makes me happy. This is really nice to be able to break up the content in that way. And yeah, all in all, the tags on this auto tagger are pretty decent. Do we still have some work to do? Yes, we do. And it's not perfect, but this looks really clean compared to a regular tag structure that you would generate using the auto tag feature, the non-API version. So with that said, let's go ahead and just run the accessibility checker just to find out where we stand with this 19-page document. We can determine that our images are missing alt text. I think we knew that already. And then what's up with our tables? Oh, they don't have headers applied. Interesting. Let's show in the tags panel. That's a pretty easy fix though. We could just change this tag from a TD to a TH and similar on those other tags. This might not even make sense to be in a table. It just sort of depends. Technically, it could just be P tags, as it doesn't necessarily make sense for it to be inside of a table structure. This list element came out fantastic. Wow, with a properly embedded figure tag inside of the list element, this is definitely an upgrade to the way that the auto tagger used to perform. We've got all these nice embedded list items. That definitely is an upgrade. Again, it's not perfect, as we have actually A, B, C, and D, but it only marked it as a single list item list. The heading structure is a little out of order. We would need to fix that. But all in all, this looks pretty good. Thank you for joining me today as we went through the new auto tag API. As always, I can be your personal accessibility expert. Check out the link in the description to find out how I can help you get accessible.